Currently, the theme of women in ministry is a very important one among believers in the body of Christ. We sometimes read passages in the New Testament that would seem to be saying, women, shut up and learn at home. The passage in 1 Timothy where Paul is calling women to remain silent, taken out of context, can basically seem to confirm a real prejudice that the Apostle Paul himself had a lot of issues about women. But really, when we take the whole Bible, the entire narrative, we begin to realize that every verse has a context that must be understood. For instance, the same apostle that wrote 1 Timothy 2 also wrote 1 Corinthians 11 when he said, women are only supposed to prophesy with their head covered, with their heads covered. Well, where do women prophesy but in the church? Where do women prophesy or hold forth their understanding of the word of the Lord for the moment except in the community of men and women together? That's just a good example of how we need to see the whole scripture in a larger context. Really, it can be best understood going back to Genesis 1 and 2, where when we read the origin of creation, God creates male and female in his own image. And Adam and Eve were both commissioned to live as complementary stewards of God's world. They were vice regents together of God's creation. In the unfolding of God's story, we see that a man and a woman are equal but different, very much like life within the Trinity. You know, we don't think of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit competing for who gets to do what. We see this glorious revelation of God in three persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Likewise, in humanity, men and women are given an equality of status but diversity of function. But a part of that diversity does not mean that a woman should remain silent at all times. Apparently, what was going on in 1 Timothy 2 and also later in 1 Corinthians 14 was there were some women acting out in an unruly fashion. And so Paul is responding to very specific situations in certain churches saying, we got to reel some of these enthusiastic ladies in, because clearly in other parts of Scripture, I mean, even in the Old Testament, there were women prophetesses. There was a woman judge, Deborah. There are many wonderful ministries for women. So we need to read the whole Bible, look at the difficult passages in the larger context, and accept the fact that we're called to be servants of Jesus, however he has called and gifted us to serve.